Well, hi everybody and welcome to my shop. I have a project coming up that I will need some epoxy resin. So I bought some from Total Boat. Not a sponsor. Why should they? They never heard of me. I'm going to have plenty of epoxy resin left over. So I might try my hand at some resin casting later on. So I've been watching Zach Higgins' videos and been learning some about how to use a pressure pot or a vacuum chamber. Just so happens we had a Harbor Freight store open up in town. Got a 20% off coupon. So I went to Harbor Freight and bought a Harbor Freight paint pot, which he showed me how to convert to a pressure pot. So mine's already converted because the idiot forgot to turn the camera on when I took all the parts that came with this paint pot and converted it to a pressure pot. Did I ever mention to you guys that Pigsty Productions is a one-man operation? Pop-off relief valve, which I had to set a little bit. It was popping off at about 32 to 35 pounds. The gauge, the regulator, all came inside the pot. The two valves came from Tractor Supply. So, I'll just explain to you how it was done. And paint pot will have this tube in it. Mine unscrewed pretty easy. Some of them are bare to get out. Discard that. So when I assembled everything together as you see it, I used thread tape that is for gas. I got everything all set up, plugged my air in, charged it up, and it would only go to about 30 to 35 pounds. And when I set the regulator to go up a little higher, I got leaks out around here. They have this plastic gasket in here that I thought would work, but it kept leaking. I couldn't wrench these things down tight enough to keep the air from leaking. So I came up with a solution. A tractor inner tube, or a piece of a tractor inner tube. Inner tubes are airtight, they hold air, so they might work. Now to make the gasket for the pressure pot lid, I just simply grabbed my measurements off the lid, and I took my compass, I replaced the pencil with the ink pen. Just start in the center. Just go. You can see that.
Again, same process, taking pin. Try to keep the inner tube flat as you can.
And you see that mark? There's your gasket. Get it cut down to size where you can handle it. Very carefully cut the line. You have a circle. There's your outside of your gasket. Now to do the inside. And these are just regular scissors. Get rid of most of the inside so you can handle it. Now you cut the inside. And there you have it, from a tractor inner tube. So I just laid that inner tube gasket that I cut out on top of the Harbor Freight gasket. Okay, my compressor pumped up. No air leaks. Set this for 50 pounds, and that's what the regulator's got set for. So I let this set for overnight, and I only lost about 2 or 3 pounds of pressure. That will hold pressure long enough. Then I got to thinking, can I make this thing do double duty? Can I turn this pressure pot into a vacuum chamber? So here's what I came up with. When I started to make the lid for the vacuum chamber out of this 3/4 inch piece of ballistic resistant plexiglass, I did turn the camera on, but I didn't pay any attention to how much battery life I had left. So needless to say, only got a few minutes and gone. So I will demonstrate all the steps it took to make this lid for the vacuum chamber / pressure pot. First, I cut a groove about 3/16 of an inch deep and 3/4 inches wide. And I set up a circle cutting jig for my trim router. Of course, I found center, and this was before I drilled the holes for the fittings. You'd route out all the way around, and I cut this inner tube out the same way I did for the pressure pot lid. Got the routing done, the gaskets cut, now it's time to assemble. Now for the pressure gauge.
I'm gonna stop there.
Put something in there. You can see it through the clear acrylic. Once you degas, bleed the pressure off, that comes off. And we'll put the pressure on it. There it goes. And we have good vacuum. And it holds vacuum for a good while. And that converts your Harbor Freight paint pot to a pressure pot or a vacuum chamber, whichever you need. If you like what you've seen in this video, please hit the subscribe button and click the little bell. Check the box so you will receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. And don't forget to give a thumbs up and please leave a comment below. And as always, God bless and thanks for watching.